Today's Wednesday Business Connection is sponsored by yours and yours only, the Bay Area Chamber of Commerce. And so on to the exciting thing that you're all here to do. Our presentation is an annual visit from the mayors of Coos Bay and North Bend with a focus on the year completed and a look at the exciting future in Oregon's Bay Areas for 2023. Mayor Jessica Engelke was elected by her community to serve the city of North Bend as mayor in November of 2020 and reselected this past November. Her current term expires in November of 2024. She had served previously as a North Bend City Council member after being elected to the position in November of 2018. Jessica's a longtime North Bend resident, invested in making our community a better place. She is a tenured business professor at Southwestern Oregon Community College and teaches a variety of business classes. Jessica is very active in the community and began her service to the city in 1990 as the North Bend July Jubilee Princess. She served now on several local boards, and in 2017 was the Bay Area Chamber of Commerce president. After having the opportunity to live in Los Angeles, New Jersey, and Amsterdam, she returned home to North Bend in 2010 with her husband, Stephen Ryan, and two daughters, Emily and Sophia. And she's remained active in the community ever since. She sure has. Jessica has over 25 years of hands-on experience in the business community, and her strategic planning skills are an asset to the city of North Bend. Come on up.
All right. Well, welcome everybody. I'm Jessica Engelke, the mayor of North Bend. And also I want to echo all of the remarks that Joe Benetti said when he was saying thank you to the chamber and also our working relationship. It's been a really treat over the last few years to work together and to move both cities forward. So thank you for that. So as I begin, I want to make sure that I introduce the council. Back today, we have one of our counselors with us, Larry Garbon. He has a foot and a boot there, so I won't make him stand. Also, we have a new Councillor Jones and Councillor Susanna Nordoff, Councillor Eric Gleason, Councillor Pat Gall, and Councillor Barbara Schultz. And one of the exciting things after the three that were newly elected, it's the first time in North Bend's history that we have a female majority. So, exciting. We have an incredible staff at North Bend, our city administrator, David Milliron. If he was ever not with the city, I think we would have to hire four people to replace all of the work that he does. Macy Janig, and she has been recently promoted to city recorder, and Jessica Terra, our finance director. We have Jim Brown, our fire chief, Ralph Dunham, public works director, Haley Legassi, our library director, Gary McCullough, our police chief, Stephanie Wilson, Main Street manager, Paul Thompson, park superintendent, and Clara McKee, our new aquatics director. So please give them all a round of applause. We're so thankful for all of the work that they put into the North Bend, and they really are the epitome of do more with less. So thank you. Before I begin on the key accomplishments of 2022, I want to just kind of walk back a little bit and tell you how we came up with our strategic plan and the goals that we set forth. We ended up having four main goals, and what's neat is we actually did this again last night to make the goals for the next 2 years after that. So how it happens is you get the council together and the staff. We all are in a room. Everybody gets kind of to go round robin style and talk about the things that they're really passionate about. And then we end up taking those items, voting on them. And it's a great way so that not one person monopolizes all the things that we want to do. And we put those in different buckets. So when we did this 2 years ago, the first goal that we came up with was to identify and secure additional revenues for long-term sustainability in our city. You know, it's no secret that the amount of money that we bring in on property taxes is barely enough to cover our public safety. So if we want to do all of those other things, how are we going to do them unless we figure out a way to secure long-term funding? Goal number two was evaluate our city services for efficient and effective city government. Are we using the money wisely that we have? Are we using the resources wisely that we have? And so it was really interesting then how we ended up finding these actionable items under each one of those. And I'll talk about that in a minute here. Goal three was to review, revise mission and vision statement ahead of any new branding that we were doing. And that, I'll, you know, spoiler alert, we're actually, that's still ongoing. That'll be part of one of the new goals this next 2 years. And then the fourth goal was to support, sustain, and seek economic vitality for all of our local businesses. I mean, isn't that why we're here? So if we break that down a little bit, the first item was goal number one, identify and secure additional revenues for the long-term sustainability of our city. So I'm happy to report last year, that's about $3.8 million in grants, state and federal appropriations for the city of North Bend. That's a lot of money. In fact, I believe the return on that is about 86 cents in outside funding matched on that. So that is one of the ways that we are able to do all of the things that we want to do in the city of North Bend. So we'll break that down a little bit on how we spent that $3.8 million or how we're continuing to be spending this money. Anybody interested in what's going on with the pool? All right, I saw a hand raised back there. So I'm really happy to report that we are getting so close. Part of that money was spent $1.4 million. This is on a new boiler that's here, it's installed. And by the way, we need to be very clear that we are replacing the items from 1954. Okay, so this is gonna be amazing when it is all finished. The new boiler is here, it's been installed. The filtration system, if I understand correctly, that's the one thing that we're waiting on. But there's other items that are involved with that. We're upgrading the showers, there's new paint, accessibility, lift, chair, pool, vacuum system, and more. So it's gonna be like a brand new pool inside. It's also important to remember that there was a bond measure or levy that was passed in the city of North Bend. And the promise was that if that levy passed, levy would pay for the operations and management for 5 years. And then that additional money that would be normally used for upkeep would be put aside for helping with the repairs. And we are keeping that commitment. And that money for the levy, even though the pool hasn't been open, sits in an account and does not start until we go ahead and open the pool. So that's been a big question in the community. So do help me get that information out. With that, too, there's some other exciting things that are happening with the pool. We received a grant to help with a fitness court at the pool. So look how amazing this is going to be. You can get out there and do some wall Pilates and let people use their own body weight to get a complete workout using 7 different exercise stations. So I think we're going to see a lot of people by the end of spring and the beginning of summer, that pool will be very full. Other funded key projects were new patrol vehicles. We needed to make sure that we were taking care of the vehicles and replacing the ones that were aging. And so we have new Dodge Durangos that you've probably seen out there. And this helps reduce vehicle-related injuries. And we also updated the design and image of the department. And that was able to be done. All of that was done without using taxpayer dollars. This is Officer Shane Dunning, and this was a key project that was funded. He is our new community resource officer. I know that he is already out there making connections and working in our community and helping people find the resources that they need. So he provides outreach to the homeless individuals and families and connects them with the community resource partners. So we are very happy that he is in that position. Rapid attack vehicle. So these are purchased 2 4-wheel drive rescue trucks to handle medical calls, vehicles, and accidents. One of the reasons why this is so important is we have an amazing public safety team, and if there is an emergency call, they fire up, they head out, and it's very expensive every time you start up the big fire trucks. So this will end up having less wear and tear on the main fire trucks when we have these trucks that can go out to these calls and the big ladder trucks aren't needed. So we had quite a few key accomplishments in the goals. I won't go over all of these in details, but I wanna highlight a few here. Many of you probably saw some of the community grants for the children, the K-12 students that we were able to put on this last summer. So it was all sorts of different things that we did with the children, but it was a total of $400,000 in state grants. And other things too to really highlight, we've got Stephanie Wilson. If you want to give your hand a wave over there, she is our new Main Street manager, and we hired her to manage our downtown area, Main Street, and grow the development and tourism. And also, she works with the Urban Renewal Agencies. So we all are really happy to have Stephanie as part of our team. We'll talk here in a bit about some different successful events that we've had and that we're going to have. And the data shows when you have a thriving, healthy downtown, everything else falls into place. And so we're very excited about those things. Goal 2 was to evaluate city services for efficient and effective city government. One of the things that we did over the last year was to transfer of the 911 dispatch. So North Bend we evaluated nearly 20 proposals to transfer dispatch services since 2000. So this is something that has been talked about for a long time, and the decision was finally made, and staff and operations transferred to the North Coos 911 call center. This is a savings of $723,000 through fiscal 2025. So that ended up being a really great move. You've got a photo here where we were recognizing, for example, we I believe that one person retired, other people moved on, and then we found some internal positions. So Macy, who's in the picture there in the kind of brown coat and is also sitting at the table, has found a new position with us and is, again, our city reporter. So key goal number 2 accomplishments, again, so many things to list. You know, the hardest part about this whole presentation is that it's 20 minutes, right, Joe? So there's so many things to mention, but I would like to talk about the Public Works Department converted to the statewide e-permitting platform. And these are all very strategic things that we have done as a city to try to make sure that we are business friendly and that we are moving as smooth and operating as smooth as possible. We've also received a state grant to complete a 20-year master plan for the parks. And again, looking at other things that we can do in the community with shared resources. So we implemented a community engagement specialist at a resource to patrons at the North Bend, Coos Bay, and Lakeside libraries. This is such a meaningful project that it is, I guess, a social worker, as you would call it, is in those libraries at different hours. And so, you know, sometimes I think as individuals, I have problems navigating the systems of who to call for what and what to do and how to get dialed into resources. So imagine if you were struggling in a different, you know, some different capacities, how hard that can be. So to have somebody with you there to walk you through certain tasks like that, or just reach out to other entities that can help you be successful in your life, is really meaningful. Goal number 3 is to review and revise our mission and vision statements ahead of the new city branding campaign. And so last night in our work session where we were doing our next set of strategic goals, we did talk about we want to continue that branding and look at everything from, you know, how is our logo still working for us? Are we doing the things in the city that we want to do? And I love this picture too, because this was at a parade that we had for all the students at North Bend High School that had been in the playoffs, or the band competition had won different titles. And so we want to be the city who is out there supporting everybody, including the youth, and I think this really embodies that. They had a really great time that day. You know, and other things that we do with that is we make sure that we do proclamations, that any sort of major sporting event or extracurricular activities, just celebrating and highlighting people in our community is very important to the staff and the council. Other key accomplishments in the goal are also to engage our tribal partners in meet and greets, and this work on the archaeological study. And these sort of things helped out when we needed to go into negotiations with Feet of Trust and just building the relationships. We want to be known as the town where, hey, if you have a question or a comment, give us a call up. Our city administrator, the chief of police, the chief of the fire department, whoever it is, let's work together and give us a call and we'll come up with solutions. Another goal, this is a really fun picture here, by the way. This is our Main Street manager is going out supporting businesses, and I'm gonna go ahead and let the secret out of the bag. That's probably not a real Main Street tattoo, but I love the spirit. It's actually, that was when she was out at the Rusty Needle Tattoo downtown North Bend. Great business, they have amazing art on the wall, totally fun vibe in there, so go down there and check them out sometime. But we want to make sure that we are supporting, sustaining, and seeking economic vitality for our local businesses. That is what is making the city go around. That is what is producing tax dollars to pay for infrastructure in our community. So it has to be a focus. So we established the Main Street program. With the Main Street program, And it's shocking to me to think that this only started in June and all of the successful events that we have had. Five successful events, each with 25 to 30 participating businesses. If a raise of hands, did anybody see what was going on like around Halloween down there? You know, it was a bit, you could hardly drive down there, seeing all of the people out. They had a candy crawl. And also as a city, what we're trying to do, yes, this is the Main Street program, but it gives us opportunities to engage other businesses as well. So we had the trunk retreat. So if you were not one of the businesses on Main Street, but you wanted to participate, then you could have your car open. It sounds really shady when I'm describing it that way, but you guys know what I mean. You have your trunk open with the candy, and you do the trunk or treat. Trust me, the kids loved it. It was really good. So there's six new businesses open downtown, so we are thriving. And some of the pictures that I come up to next, see how we're doing on time here, are some of my favorites, because you really can see with your very own eyes it happening right in front of you. And with the Main Street program, by the way, once that was established, we were able to secure $174,000 through the Main Street program of a matching grant for the Liberty Theater's Blade sign, and they're using that for stage curtains and the sidewalks as well. So it is incredible to see the transformation of the Liberty Theater, and we like to talk about how when the neon blade comes in, we're going to be able to bookmark both ends of the town with neon, so it's really something special. Continuing on with economic development, we were able to use transient lodging tax dollars to purchase a synthetic ice skating rink to drive tourism during slow months. And we are also, we purchased a very large tent to put the ice skating rink in, and we're able to, and so thank you TSOC, Travel Southern Oregon Coast, and the board members that are part of that. We will be having lots of other events with that event tent. It has been wildly successful. It is so fun to go down and to see not only the people in our community, but the people outside of our community, because this is exactly what we wanted it to do, is draw people in. So we've had conversations with people from around the state, even visiting from different areas. Who wants to self-admit, who's tried the ice skating already? So I think Steve Nye, I saw you out there once. Yeah, a few of you. It's hard, but it's been really fun. We're also, you know, the average rink, we have about 400 guests on the weekend. We've had, and that's not even including the private parties. So there's a few private parties that are coming up. We're running that till just about, I believe, February 18th or so. And so make sure that you check the City of North Bend Facebook page or the website to get the hours, because it's not too late to get in the fun times. I really encourage all of you to do that. All right, this is super exciting to me. The economic development continues with what is happening down in really on Highway 101. So we've made some very strategic land acquisitions using the urban renewal dollars to purchase the intersection of Sherman Avenue, Highway 101, California Avenue, and downtown. And this will be a future town square with public restrooms and drinking fountains. So if you're able to really kind of take a look at the picture here, I believe years ago it used to be a gas station, right? Okay, there was a gas station there, and then at one point there was a little small white building, and that was a coffee cart, so that you can kind of orient yourself, and then you see the old Stebbins and Coffee building behind that. And the reason why I say the old Stebbins and Coffee building behind that is because the City of North Bend's Urban Renewal Agency did purchase that building, and that will be the home of our new visitor center. Round of applause for that, yes. And the reason why I say that is probably many of you have driven over the bridge from time to time and go, was that the visitor center back there? And so we think that's probably what a lot of people from our community has said. It doesn't make sense to have it right there at the beginning of town when you come in. And there's things that are even structurally wrong with that building. So when we're good windstorm, we wouldn't have the visitor center there anyways. This is gonna be amazing because we'll have our and people who are traveling, there'll probably be room for RVs to park there. And it does what we want it to do, which is to get people to come into downtown and spend money at our local businesses. So again, this is the tent. So this is what the tent looks like as they were setting up the ice skating rink. And you can see we can do all sorts of things in there. 4,980 square feet. It's that can withstand more wind than the current visitor center, let me put it that way. Okay, it's very strong. And again, St. Patrick's Day weekend, March 18th, It'll be really fun. All right, so economic development is continuing. We're talking about the facade grants. We had several different businesses took advantage of the facade grants this year. Of course, one of them was the Wildflower Cafe that you'll see in a moment. Do want to point out the mural there, which was done by a local artist, Simon Whiteowl, and that was actually done by the local business owner. And it's so neat when you see the different businesses that are investing in the community, because I think Joe used the word before, it's contagious. And we're really seeing that trickle down. So here is the Gino's Pizza Inn. They use the facade grant, and they've got a nice kind of roof slash awning there. The next one, does anybody recognize what that building is now? That's what Wildflower is. So it went from the old pellet stove to an incredibly inviting open bar during the summertime. Perfect, you know, if you want to take your dog down there and sit on the sidewalk and enjoy a beverage in one of their famous charcuterie boards. And then the, look at this one. What is that? It's old Simpkins Music. I used to buy my daughter's saxophone from there, and there it is now. I mean, these are night and day. And so we have an upscale thrift shop there called Dream Again Emporium. And I was actually talking, this is the proceeds from this go to the Devereaux Center. And they will take some small items there if you are looking at a way, if you want to donate things, but much of their larger items should go down to the Devereaux Center so that they can, that's their sorting center. But if it's something small, you can drop it off there. So I just want to say thank you to everybody in the community that works so hard, because you look around this room and there's a lot of business owners that are taking time away from their business to be here. There's people that are involved in all sorts of things. And when you come together as a community, amazing things can happen. So again, thank you to the city of Coos Bay for being incredible partners. Thank you for everybody's for making our town great. And thank you for having me here speak today.